Hello guys and welcome back, this is Player and welcome back to another episode of me playing FTB Infinity Evolved on my friend's server with my friends, and there's only my dear friend Panda online for now. So as you can see, the server world has changed quite a lot, and there are 3 turbines here for the energy generation, the big reactors below here. And they work pretty well. They are all built by Mr. Jack, and he's not online now. But they work pretty well, and they provide quite a lot of power, and which is pretty cool. So let's continue. And there's not been a lot of changes here, but I've made just a few more lava generators here to make it faster. The lava energy generation faster, and hopefully it works. And let me see, is this working? I do think it is. Can I turn this back off? And now they shouldn't be working, but if I turn this on, perhaps I haven't loaded chunks inside Nether, so perhaps I'll do that now. Let me first go load the chunks, which is a pretty important job. Let's see. So getting to the Nether is quite troublesome, as it would be quite laggy when I try to enter Nether while recording. Never mind, I'll get into all the changes happened here step by step. Okay, so here we are in the Nether, and here is the 4 pipes for this thing, and they are working pretty well, but I think I need to claim some chunks around here. Okay, chunk loaded. Oh, well, I don't know why they're not getting much lava in the overworld. Let me try to get back. This is weird. Perhaps I'll rely on the big reactor energy for now. Never mind, let's get back to the overworld and hopefully not crash the server. Okay, here we are back to the overworld, and it's raining once again. And I think Panda has to do something about this. This is so annoying. Okay, so so there's been quite a lot of changes. As you can see, there are the 3 energy plants, as I've told you, and Jack has been doing quite a lot of magical stuff, witchery, etc. And he's built some cool little contraptions up here to get to his base. And so this is currently his base, and not the creeper. Those were the items. They work too. I didn't know that. Okay, never mind. Let's get back. The immersive engineering district hasn't been changed a lot. As you can see, there are still a few machineries right here, but they're not really functioning very well for us. And Jack has also been doing some enslaving of the goblins, which doesn't seem to be working very well now. I think he will just fix that and just leave that. So there's been a cactus farm that I don't know why it is necessary, and some blood magic made by Panda here as well. Some random cobblestone. And I think there was a smeltery right here. I don't know in the last episode that I mentioned, that was an extremely tall smell tree right here, and that was used to smelt up the ores came from the inner quarry that was overloading the enemy system. And yeah, so underground, actually before underground, is there anything I need to show you? There's not a lot of things. This is the deep dock which we get all our ores from. And yeah, I didn't think there is a lot of things here. Let's set the time to zero. Let's not fail typing. Okay, finally. So here is the main base area, but people still get down, and there's not been a lot of changes here except for the energy generation here, which is working pretty well, I should say, but not really as good as the big reactors do. Okay, so these are providing power to everything, and there's just a slight problem of the elevator problem here, which I can't really fix, and it's quite a pain in the ass to fix. As you can see, there is some energized glowstone to keep the place lit up, but well, there is elevator block here, as you can see, and it directly jumps to this block, and I don't think there is anything wrong with that. Yeah, there is nothing wrong with that, and I don't know why it doesn't work. Oh, now I know why it doesn't work. Just a second. There's too much blocks in the way, so it doesn't work. I think it is the reason. Let me fix this hole. Okay, so I think now it works. Yep, now it works. And yeah, this is the enemy system that I've expanded the room, and Panda has also added a lot of automating stuff, but that actually failed very miserably. So I decided to reconstruct the whole place, and now it looks pretty much just a little bit cleaner. And these are still not functional for now, but well, I guess that'll do some preparation work for the future molecular assembler things, and we'll do some automation in this area as well, and of course in this area as well, for automation of other things like crafting recipes or smelting recipes, etc. So I've also added two deep storage units here to keep the cobblestone and the normal stone, because they were overloading the enemy system too badly. And let me see, well, now the enemy system isn't facing quite a lot of stress, and the structure isn't really that looking good, but well, it functions. And yeah, I've made some original, there are no these lines here, they were just here to these are dense cables, they are here to keep the channels from overloading. Is that how it's called? Never mind. So now there's a dense cable here to keep two sides not overloading. And yeah, and here are some export buses to the oil processing units in the slime island. If you had a clear eye or sharp eye, you would have seen that it became quite a lot like a square. So now this island is no longer my base, and it's currently doing jobs of oil processing. And as you can see, these are auto forging machines, and you can see the magical pickaxes here that they can give fortune and haste and reinforced X to get an effective durability of the defendant. And yeah, so they all function as the auto fortune machine, and XP collected will be transferred into this tank, which is equivalent to these two tanks as well, and you can just store your XP here and you can look at them going down. And if you want some XP, you can just stand here and AFK for a while and you get yourself some XP. And that's one way, and you can also store your XP by standing on the drain. And they will be converted into the mod essence, and be stored inside this Batrockian drum. And this sewage drum is just for redirecting all the unnecessary things. And this actually has another floor, so let's go down. And this is the ore processing units. As you can see, it's pretty big. Yeah. Well, what we are doing is we are... well, let's actually explain it cell by cell. So I would consider every line of these to be one cell. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cells in this room. So what it's doing here is, let's explain this cell first. So this cell is getting all the iron, actually not only iron, they're getting all the smeltable things into the chest, and then they are going to be combined with the cinnabar inside the induction smelter. And let's see, well, it's not going so well. As you can see, it's currently working just fine to keep up with this, and hopefully it works, because I actually just built it. And the concept behind it was that every iron ore, let's actually look at the cinnabar inside any ice in the... Okay, so that's how you spell cinnabar. And cinnabar smelting with any other ores would give extra ingots. And as you can see, if they smelt the iridium, no, not the iridium, the ferrous ore or the nickel ore, they would give shiny ingots, which we need. Well, where's that? Oh, here it is. And it would give shiny ingots, which we need for mandarium. So now we do have quite a lot of shiny ingots, as you can see, and they all come from this machine. And yeah, so what I'm doing is I'm getting the cinnabar, and let's check where cinnabar comes from. Cinnabar comes from pulverizing redstone or gold, but pulverizing gold isn't really that good of a deal, because it's only 5% chance, and pulverizing redstone ore is actually much higher chance. And you can also do it by adding gelid cryophrium into cinnabar ore from craft, but I think that wastes a lot of cryophrium and it's not really a good idea, so I do not use that method. And let's see, these are all the same ways to getting it. And yeah, so basically what I've done is I've set up an ender chest just for resin ore, and whenever there is resin ore inside the emission, as you can see, there was a glimpse of resin ore here, and they are going to be taken into these pulverizer with a very high chance of getting the cinnabar out, and then they are going inside the ME system using the white ME chest. And yeah, so basically we have one line of cell of those here. Sorry for the lightning. Okay, so we have one line of that doing what I've just said here. Two lines, three lines, four lines, six line. Wait a second. That should be five lines. Anyways, so five cells doing the same thing, in order to get ourselves enough cinnabar to smelt the iron and other ores. So that is 7 out of 8 cells working, and the last cell is actually pretty cool. It takes all dense ores out and it pulverizes them into 4 each. Each of them can be pulverized into 4, so what it's doing is this just pulverizing it, and I've used a speed upgrade on that as well. So yeah, so this room is pretty much all what I've just said, and there's actually one floor down which is very useless, but just for fun. That's the system to let you jump down into the base area. So that's just a contraption that uses block placer and block breaker, and then the vacuum hopper placing back the block into the block placer, and with a trip wire doing the rest of the signal thing, and that's pretty much it. And yeah, so I think that's pretty much all the physical things you can see that changed. And the next thing I would like to talk about is my armory. So as you can see, I've got myself some draconic evolution things, and they are actually not that hard to make, I have to say. They require quite a lot of diamonds, quite a lot of draconium, quite a lot of diamonds and draconium and nether star, and quite a lot of energy, but we actually have excess of all those. As you can see, if we check on the diamond situation, we are having 5,000 and more, and there are still just a few more diamond swords to be fortuned out in the system. And I have to say, it is not really that expensive for me, but that's just the normal draconium, and there is still one more tier to go up, which is the awakened draconium. The awakened draconium actually need the heart of dragon, I think that's how you say it, and they look like some bright orange things, and they are pretty powerful, but I can't do it yet because we have not found ourselves any dragon, which means we haven't found any we actually found ourselves a stronghold, but after me and Panda keep exploring the entire stronghold, we cannot find any and portal right there, so we kind of give up right on that day, and we didn't actually do much more of those kinds of exploring. So yeah, we are waiting for more players to get on server, and we can go find ourselves the end portal and fight the ender dragon and also the draconic evolution dragon, and I think that would be pretty much end game stuff. So yeah, before that we are going to do just a few more of the NG stuff, and maybe some draconic evolution generator, some reactor stuff. So yeah, and the other thing that I've made is the Enderium pickaxe. If you've paid much attention, before I was using the manual pickaxe, and I don't know if it's still in the NG system. Yes, it is, and I was using this manual pickaxe, which is pretty cool, but it is not really a fast miner, but well, it's pretty fast. Mining speed 21 is pretty fast, but I found that well, before that, cobalt was the fastest mining material in Tinker's Construct, but after a lot of research and just doing some investigation around on the Tinker's Construct stuff, and we found that Enderium is actually the fastest, I believe the fastest material you can mine with, and I've done an example even to make an Enderium pickaxe, which is extremely fast, I have to say, and it repairs as well. The mining speed is 62, which I've never seen something as fast as that, and it's pretty insane. So Yeah, if you guys want any fast miners, be sure to choose Ethereum other than Cobalt. And that's why I've changed this to Ethereum pickaxe. And I do believe I've used some magical wood on this pickaxe as well, so that I could have more modifiers. And yeah, and also I've made myself a flux infused bow, and rather than the OP bow from Things Construct as well, the crossbow with the bolt, which deals like nearly 100 hearts, I'm not going to use that anymore because it's just a little bit too OP. And yeah, so I changed to use this flux infused bow, and I added some infinity and XP boost, power 5, flame and multi-shot, which you may have seen in the beginning of the episode, that I shot the mobs on Mage Tower with multi-shot, and as you can see, that is pretty deadly. As you can see, I killed two of that, and it drops quite a lot of XP as well. Basically, it has much larger XP orbs when you kill the mobs, as you can see. Yep, so it's pretty cool, and I like this bow very much, actually more than that of the OP bow, the crossbow with the bolts. And yeah, so I don't know if I've mentioned that, but I've also made myself the red hot canister here, and these are nothing special. And there's still one more feature in the slime island, which I'm not really heading into. What's Mage Tower? This is Mage Tower, and there's the slime island, I believe. Here. Oh, the server is dying. Whoops. Okay, the slime tower's here, the slime island's here. So, sorry for the lag. And there's one thing inside this slime island, and that is the auto charging station. As you can see, there's actually a tesseract here with a hidden charging station, and that charges my jet plate pretty fast and pretty seamlessly. And yeah, so I guess that's all I've got time for today, actually. But yeah, I'm going to talk with my friends and do a few more things around in this server, and I'll see you guys next time. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode in the series and server tour and stuff for all. And yeah, I'm glad to be back on the YouTube channel that I've abandoned for a few days. Anyways, so I guess that's it for today, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.